Can we use deep groove ball bearing in an axial loading condition also? If yes, then up to what limit? And what about cylindrical roller bearings? Can we use it in axial loading condition? So hey there, this is Ayush from Master Mechanical Design, and today we will deeply understand all types of thrust bearing. Plus we will also end this confusion. So as we have seen in the first part of bearing series with an example of car wheel, the basic design of bearing like general bearing, deep groove ball bearing and cylindrical roller bearing. And the loading direction we assume was the pure radial. So let's first deeply understand what is the radial loading and what is the axial loading, or we can say thrust loading. Because the loading direction is the foundation of understanding different types of bearing. So in this car example, the load is the weight of the car, gravitational force of the car, and the load on bearing is along the bearing radius, in the direction of bearing radius. So we call it radial load over the bearing. And the bearing which is designed for taking radial load, we call it radial bearing, like deep groove ball bearing, cylindrical roller bearing or needle bearing. And we can also say in radial loading condition, the load is perpendicular to the shaft, to the rotational axis of the bearing. But this is not necessary that the load can be only from top or can be from bottom. The load can be applied from any side, or maybe multiple loads from multiple side. But the load should be in the direction of bearing radius, in radial plane. We will consider all those load as a radial load. And now let me take in another example. Let's say we have this bicycle. So at the both wheels, load is from top due to the weight of bicycle and the driver, and from the bottom due to the weight reaction force on the ground. So we can simply use radial bearing in bicycle wheel, deep groove ball bearing. And now what about bearing in handle, in this steering? Let's pay close attention here. So this is the bicycle body part, and this is the handle moving rod attached with front wheel. And now what is happening here? What is the direction of load? The load is the weight force of bicycle body part and the driver, and the direction is same towards downward. So can we use deep groove ball bearing in handle also? You already know the answer, but let's place the deep groove ball bearing right here. And we have to place the bearing in such a way that the bearing can keep the handle and body at a place, keep them constrained, as well as enable the relative motion with less friction. This is the definition of the bearing actually. So what we can do? We can fix the bearing inner race by making a step on handle rod, and we can use an external circlip, something like this. And we can fix the bearing outer race with the body by making this bore, and we can use an internal circlip to completely fix it within the bore. And now the handle rod and body is completely constrained, and it's also free to rotate. So what is the difference between wheel's bearing arrangement and this bearing arrangement? Because the direction of load is the same vertically downward, same as on the wheels. But the thing is, here the load is not along the radius of bearing. Load is along the rotational axis of bearing. So for this bearing, the load is axial. Load is thrust. So what will be happen here? Since we can see the direction of load is axial to the bearing, inner race will try to go down and the outer race will try to come up. It's like a shear force. And because the balls are trapped in the groove, ball is trying to keep holding the inner race and the outer race together in a place. But the holding area is just a small arc contact in the direction of axial force. It's a half arc from both sides. Of course, there is a large contact area, but this is in the radial direction. But the load is in axial direction. So if we will increase the load, and as the support is just a little arc here, after a limit, ball will easily get damaged. Even if ball will be not damaged, but in running condition, ball will wear out at the heavy loading, and as a result, reduction in service life of the deep groove ball bearing. So what is the solution? What we should do? We should change the contact support direction according to the direction of load. Something like this. Now, the ball is fully supported in pure axial direction, and we can call it thrust bearing. The bearing which is designed for thrust load, we call it thrust bearing. And there is one more major difference between radial bearing and the thrust bearing. In thrust bearing, we cannot trap the ball inside the race. It's like a burger or sandwich. Balls with the cage and the both side plates are completely separate. Integrated design is not possible in thrust bearing. So we always get low speed in thrust bearing as compared to radial bearing. So a simple thrust bearing series like 51 can take the load only in one direction. Like here, as we are supporting the bearing from bottom, the loading is only possible in downward direction. Load in upward direction will not support it by this bearing. But when the bicycle will jump on uneven track, the bicycle handle could jump in upward direction also. So to fix it, we can place one more thrust ball bearing to support the load in upward direction, and we use a chuck nut to tighten these arrangement to keep it in the place. And my main purpose to explain this through this example was there is no specific name of the direction of load. The name of loading direction is depend on the direction in which we applied the load on the bearing, whether it is axial or radial. And now let's understand the different design of thrust bearing. So there are mainly two types of thrust ball bearing. One, the single directional thrust ball bearing 51 series for ID more than 10 mm. And in this design, there are two plates at the top and bottom, and we call this seat washer. One is a soft washer which have to interference fit on the soft, and the second is hosing washer, which will be always larger than soft washer bore, so that the soft can easily rotate. And the second design is double direction thrust ball bearing. The intermediate washer is the soft washer in the middle, interference fit to the soft, and two hosing washer at the both end, something like this. And these all parts are separated. And for the initial misalignment, there is one more variant in both design. Bearing with spared hosing washer, this can accumulate the initial misalignment. And if the load is heavy, just replace the ball with the rollers. Because as we have seen in the first part of this series, rollers make the line contact and can carry heavy loads. And we call it cylindrical roller thrust bearing. And there is also single and double cylindrical roller thrust bearing. And if the space is very limited, replace these cylindrical rollers with needle thrust bearing. And there are two types of needle thrust bearing: needle roller and cage thrust assembly. And second, needle roller thrust bearing with centering flange, something like this. And this is all about the thrust bearings. And now, you might be say that Ayush, as you said, when we increase the load beyond a limit in axial direction on deep groove ball bearing life will be reduced. So what is the limit? Or is that deep groove ball bearing is designed for both loading condition, axial as well as radial? So yes, we can use the deep groove ball bearing in axial loading condition also. But the axial load should be less than half of its basic static load rating, C0, which we can check for the specific model of the bearing in bearing catalog like SKF catalog. But for the lighter series of the deep groove ball bearing, like the bearing nomenclatures start with 60 or 62, it's a light series deep groove ball bearing. consider axial load carrying capacity 1/4, not half, 1/4 of basic static load rating C0. We will discuss all these terms in very much detail in bearing selection series. But for now, we can directly check this value in bearing catalog. But always remember, any excessive load or any peak load in axial direction can lead to considerable reduction in bearing service life. So in short, deep groove ball bearing can very well withstand pure radial load and also some amount of axial load. And now what about cylindrical roller bearing? Can these bearing take load in axial direction? So it's a very logical thing. So as you can see, if we will apply the load axially, the load will be on circular face of the roller and this will make large contact area, means too much friction during the motion. So we cannot achieve the high speed. So never use cylindrical roller bearing in axial loading condition. Even though flange cylindrical roller bearing is not perfect for axial loading. So far we have studied, there are mainly three basic rolling elements of the bearings, ball, roller and needle. If the load is light, ball bearing are more suitable because ball bearing enables high speed due to less contact area, point contact area. And if the load is heavy, roller element bearing are more suitable. But we cannot enable high speed like a ball bearing due to line contact area. And there are radial bearings with all three rolling elements designed for radial load. And there are thrust bearings with same rolling elements designed for axial loading. But in the real world situation, load cannot be always pure radial or pure axial. Load can be at some angle also. Like in this car example, the load is pure radial only when the car is at rest or moving in a straight line. When we will turn the car, a thrust load will be also applied on the bearing. And in this situation, we use angular contact bearing. So let's understand the different type of angular contact bearing in next part of this series. So the video should be on your screen or you can check the description. Or if the video is not on the screen, it's just on our way. Thank you so much for the watching.